the people at the bottom that are trying to get to the top. And those people are climbing up to the top with the guy on the top that is, you know, eating wealthy, having riches, and having this, having the blast of it, like, the time. That's the person that's targeted. That's the person that's living the dream right now, that's getting everything they want. But the thing they gotta worry about, they don't know. They really don't know. They don't know who's, like, in back of them. They don't know that somebody's, like, could just go up behind their back and just slit their throat. And I feel like that's what being an underdog is, that you just prove everybody wrong.
Fast when you do what you want. I guess I'm doing what I want. Hope you know what you want. What else? What you want?
I don't know.
My noob look like Halle Berry, but she don't love me, she too scary. My old run like Jackie Brown.
You funny.
I don't wanna know, but she too down. Do you be my leading lady? I want a contract, girl, no maybe. In the meantime,
guess I'm doing what I want.
Guess I need time.
But you know what you want.
Maybe I love myself, I don't know. Leave me here, I'll myself. See me in the mirror, I duck myself.
But I think these boys were here when I got this. One of them were like there. So basically, it always happens when you're about to end like practice or something. Somebody gets injured or something, and that's exactly what happened to me. We were almost done with practice, but my coach wanted us to scrimmage one more. And we were going against like guys, like the varsity boys. I think most of them were seniors, but mostly like they're all on varsity. One of them was a girl that she graduated already, but she scrimmages us like to just help us out, like to have fun, because I think she's going to college this year. She just graduated. So we're on defense. My team's on defense, they're on offense. And she's driving to the basket, and she blows by my teammate. So obviously I'm in help side, so I'm trying to help over, trying to hedge. And she's trying to like get a foul call. So she like brings up her arms and my face is right here. And it just hit. And I thought it was just like a bruise.
But it was funny though.
What?
And who did I say it was? Jade. Yeah. I knew as soon as like the coach set the play, and what happened, I knew at that moment it was Jay, because she's the only one that's aggressive.
Mm-hmm. And then I thought it was a bruise until, because we were going against the high school boys, and they said, oh my God, she's gushing like a lot of blood, like help her. I started looking down, like where am I gushing blood from? And then I just see that like the whole floor is full of blood. It's just dripping and it doesn't stop. And nobody gave me like a paper towel until like 2 minutes later.
The girl said that she was like helping you out by like closing it for you, applying pressure. You owe that girl something.
She kept saying, I'm so sorry. It felt like I was in shock at first because I was losing a lot of blood, so I didn't know what was going on. Like, I saw the blood and I was like, how am I gushing this much blood? Like, I felt like it was just an elbow, but like when I like went into the room to get like, what's it called, to put bandages on, he's like, oh no, you like, you're gonna need stitches, like it's open. And then my head started pounding. I'm like, oh yeah, it hurt. It's starting to hurt now.
Mentally, how are you feeling though? Besides physically.
Oh.
Give
me a napkin, and then I run to the athletic trainer. He puts some, like, he cleans me up. I'm still, like, gushing blood. Like, my brother said when I got in the car, I smelled like iron. Like, that's how much I was bleeding, but yeah. And my worst fear is to get stitches, and I got stitches, so that was really good. I feel like being in Mexico for like 3 weeks, like every day is like basketball, 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 basketball. So I don't know, I feel like as well, like, I mean, I've been to Mexico camp before, like, I've been in like U15 last year, but I wasn't there for that many days. I feel like this time I was there for like 3 to almost 4 weeks. That's like the longest I've been out of home. And I feel like that was the longest like I've been in Mexico. And it helped me more with just having more IQ too. Having more understanding of the game, especially because when I was playing out there, like, it's way faster, it's way more aggressive. It's like, I mean, here it's fast, but it's not as fast as there. Everything's very quick. So I feel like your reaction, your IQ, just information and like collecting information as well. I'm grateful to be here because as well in Mexico, I didn't understand Spanish. I mean, I understand Spanish, but I can't speak it. But I would just have to like really lock in of what my coach is saying. So I feel like my focus has like gotten really better. And yeah, but like I definitely agree with my brother that my work ethic has like gotten better. Just wanting to be in the gym more, wanting to work on my shot, wanting to be a sponge, absorb information. That's pretty much it, but. It is really hot. My head hurts. It's great to be back though in the gym, like doing more. Like I'm trying to like slowly get back to it, but obviously I feel like I had a really fun time for my first few high school games as a freshman on varsity. Just like having fun, you know, being with my teammates. And no, I'm really excited. Just really excited for my high school season coming up. So, and high school, like I've been homeschooled for. I'm gonna say 3 years. 3 years. Yeah, I told my mom that, and she's like, "No, basically 2." I'm like, "No, no." I've been at home, like, and like I feel like high school. Yeah, I really don't know what to expect in high school.
But I can't curse on here, but I know
that I'm going to have a really fun time. And I know
I said I would have cursed right there, but I can't.
My high school season is going to be a great one. I'm not going to say I didn't have the best middle school season. I'm going to say it was okay. It wasn't like what I expected. Like, I felt like there was a lot more I wanted to do. There's a lot of more, like, things I wanted to play. Stuff just doesn't go as planned.
I remember I just got the stitches on and I couldn't do a lot of facial expressions, and I listened to music a lot and I literally couldn't scream in the music, or like I was literally this in the music. It was depressing, seriously. I mean, there's still things like I can't do, like the second day I got stitches, Marco was like making me laugh or talking about like something funny, and I couldn't laugh. Like every time I tried to laugh, I felt like this was about to be like open or something. So I couldn't laugh.
Mm-hmm. that, what's next? I guess just preparing for high school, for upcoming games. I think we have a couple of tournaments coming up because obviously we play during off season before we enter our season of high school. But I think we have tournaments coming up, so I'm excited for those. But you know, you never know what to expect. Like I didn't think, you just don't know what to expect. And you can't expect that much. If it doesn't go that way, it doesn't go that way. I mean, God didn't want it to go that way. So, but somebody told me like, oh, you're gonna miss like being in Mexico, your teammates and everything. And I'm like, I don't know. I mean, like I'll be excited to be home. And now that I'm home, I kind of do miss like being with my teammates, you know, having breakfast with them, having my roommate. Even though my roommate only speaks Spanish, I can understand her and she was really funny. goofing around with my teammates, even though we didn't speak the same language, like they still speak English, but it was really fun. I had a really, really fun experience. So I'm just glad that happened. And this dude forgot his wallet, so I gotta go get him.
Mexico didn't go as I wanted it to be, of like just playing. Like, but I got a lot of good things out of it. You know, I had fun out there. I made friends. But I don't think everything in life is gonna go your way. And I think it's just a lot of life lessons to overcome and to understand. At the end of the day, you're still gonna be in the gym. At the end of the day, you're still gonna go back home. You're still gonna work out. You're still gonna do your same routine. Nothing's gonna change either when good or bad. And that's what you have to accept. Like, oh, this thing didn't go as planned, or I didn't do as good as I wanted to.
Give me that shit.
Oh, give me that shit.
Either way, if you did good, I was gonna do my same routine. Even way I did bad, I'm gonna do my same routine. But you can't predict what's gonna happen, because the moment, that's what I've learned, is when you predict what's gonna happen, it doesn't go that way. It doesn't go, like, I can tell you the amount of times I've thought or gotten like so ready for a moment in my life and it didn't go as planned. Like, there's so many. You can't predict what's gonna happen next. You just gotta let it flow. It could be good or bad. It could be better than you expected. It could be worse than you expected. You just gotta let it go. Stop having expectations all the way up to here, because those expectations can go higher or can go low. And you just gotta deal with that at the end of the day, but don't have, like, don't do that to yourself, because either way, it can go good or bad, but you can't predict what's gonna happen.
It's so like dry right now because like I sweat so much on it. It's so hard not to sweat, Eddie.
Like Eddie sweats just holding the camera.
Yeah. leave YouTube. I technically just took a break, and I felt like that break was longer than I expected. Probably wondering why I took that break. Mostly for myself. You know, I put YouTube always first, and I just didn't put myself first, and as well basketball. And I wanted to enjoy a little bit of being a kid, I guess, and focusing more on basketball and school. I felt like YouTube, you know, I love doing YouTube. I love inspiring you guys. I love you guys watching and supporting me. But as well, I love basketball. And I think I needed to take a break to spend more time with it. Biggest assumption about me is that a lot of people think I'm an influencer more than a basketball player. And it gets me annoyed because I'm not just an Instagram girl. I'm not just a YouTube girl. I'm a basketball player, and I'm always going to be a basketball player.
Okay, cool. All right, we're going to get to a split again, all right? We're going to come off this tight. We're going to go first three. Boom. We're going to split. I want you attacking the left side completely. Boom, we're going here. One, two, sorry, you got shorter steps. Two dribbles, okay? One, two, we're gonna go left, right, and then I want you veering and getting to this side, okay? So again, I'm attacking left, right? I'm trying to draw them that way. I'm going left, right, and then I'm jumping and veering back this way. Like you're rolling it through. Oh. Good, 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 good. Go push up in her, push up in her. Nice. Good, Izzy. Here we go, here we go. Eyes up, eyes up. I'm here. Oh. Come on, two more, two more. Good, throw it to me. Set her up, set her up, set her up. Here we go. Full speed, full speed. Boom. That was a good one.
That's why I as well took a break from YouTube and everything to here we focus go. Fight more through, fight on my through. Work to get more good. Better. And I felt like a lot of people were like, do you want to be a influencer or do you want to be a basketball player? And it would get me annoyed because I thought I am a basketball player. And it's just those questions get me upset that people think that about me, which is in the wrong.
What is good, guys? So right now we are in Malibu. I'm gonna get some work in sand dunes with my trainer James. We were here in May or April, and with just like us, like training. But today's actually a pretty good day. It's sunny. It's not too like sunny, but it's sunny, even though it's cloudy right now. But we're gonna get some work in, so stay tuned.
Facing this way, is you can push the band right here. Boom, hold 10 seconds. Five, six, seven.
I've been in situations that you would think that this girl would quit. You would think that this girl would break down or quit basketball. And I'm still here at the end of the day.
And you're trying to push this over, right?
Yeah. Keep your chest this way and then you're trying to push it.
Cold, just slid on my jet. Sweaty, give me mop with the left
foot to change direction.
So, am I sliding or am I running?
Running. Right. So, walk through. Just walk. So, when you get here, you want to use your inside foot to change direction.
Left.
No, no, no.
Boom.
And now I'm pivoting and changing.
Oh.
And then I get here, play my right. Boom. Change direction. Get up the hip.
Okay.
Alright.
I can't wait to live in glory and eternity. Won't you take a will? I recline as I stand.
Like you're getting around the screen.
Oh, okay.
You know the future to bounce.
Catch that ball or else that small family of trio will
We stay like right here, right? Or no, more closer.
Yeah, you go down a bit. So, Marco's gonna throw the ball either side. You're either laterally sliding, sprinting, or with a cross on the step to get to the ball. It's not gonna be that far because he can only throw this way. Then when you get that ball, I want you to say you're over here. I want you to take that step foot. Don't throw it under, don't try to chest pass. Yeah. And then if you're on that side, you'll lead with your left foot. Boom. So the rotational throw is really good.
Boom.
Because you get the power out of your hips.
Okay.
You're gonna go four of these. So catch, throw, go throw wherever, catch, throw back. On the fourth one, scoop the ball. Overhead sprint all the way through.
Oh, should like overhead sprint to the middle or?
Just to the cone, wherever you are.
Okay.
So you might like scoop the ball over here.
And have to run to this cone.
And overhead, yeah. And we'll go three of these. You got a ton of time to rest.
Okay.
Ready? You can like left with your elbows right here.
Because my fame, bitch, that she ashamed.
Oh, got me
pepper, rebel, and privacy. Count so much money to my skin peel. Cherry red beans like the real peel. My bro cook up dope, it take real skill. Show my bitch with my hoe, ain't got no chill. You eat again, so money, you nice. Gossip. She told her, put on stone, and she's lying. I can see the future is looking like we love yours. I can't wait to live in glory and eternal justice. Won't you take the wheel? I recline in our sisters. Might as well turn up now. He gon' pop up on the now. To the trumpets. Do you like the way it sounds? Sounds, 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 sounds.
Very impressed. That's what I'm talking about.
So, do that and then go off.
Yeah. It's like a double slide.
You can see the future is a sparkling your eye when you wall up on
the. I miss doing YouTube, but I needed to tell people that I'm a basketball player, and to those people that think that I'm just an influencer, you got it all wrong.
It's good, guys. Did you guys miss me? A lot of people would say, oh, it's close to my house. But no, I chose Canyon because I feel like I could finally be me. I could finally be Izzy. Canyon is gonna be a great fit for me as a basketball player,
but as a student. And I feel like just playing in like the summer league we've been on, I felt like I could be me. I have no trouble playing, of like being nervous, being scared, or anything like that. I feel free, and I feel comfortable. And that's what you want on a team. You don't want to feel anxious when you want to play. You don't want to be scared and make mistakes. I feel like everybody should get that opportunity to play the way they want to. And the way they, you know, work out, the way they practice for themselves, you should be able to do that on any team you want. And I feel like Canyon is the way to go for me. And I feel like I'm gonna have a lot of fun this year.
Es otra cosa. Ella veía cute, mami, linda, peligrosa. Ella es maestra y da clase a la envidiosa. Tome nada rápido que de cámara y posa.
Why Star Girl? I don't know. I feel like Star Girl kind of represents my life. And I like the song by The Weeknd and Lana Del Rey. I love that song, but I feel like we needed a name to kind of represent like how I feel. Like everywhere I go, it's either at basketball, it's either at school, it's either in public or anywhere I go. That's basically my life, like Star Girl. Like the spotlight's always on me. I'm always noticeable, and I feel like all eyes are on me, and that's what Star Girl kind of means. I feel like my worth ethic like represents my goals. I feel like the way I work here at, what time is it? 9 o'clock on a school night, still have homework to do. You know, had practice earlier, later on. Just finished the workout and just finished the track right now. And about to get home, take a shower, do homework, and then get to sleep. Then get to school, then go to practice. That's just my like everyday thing, and I feel like my worth ethic pushes that. It makes my goals who they are, because you know I set a standard for myself and I'm like, okay, I can achieve these goals, or you know what, let's work harder for these goals. And I feel like that's what pushes, like that's what makes everybody like push harder. I feel like you need to set yourself a goal, you need to set yourself like what you want to do, and then you just like attack those goals.
You're not ranked. I have no offers. Like, what is really motivating you still?
I feel like that I just love basketball, and I feel like I put in so much of basketball. I put in so much of time, of sacrificing time with, like, family. It could be either my time, your time, Eddie's time. Just, like, and I don't want that just to be for nothing. I want that to be, you know, all of those sacrifices, all of those late night workouts, all those late nights that I didn't want to do it, all those mornings I didn't want to do it, were not for nothing. They were not pointless. And just of how much I love basketball.
Really, you brought that?
So this was,
all the work's not for nothing. That's all I know. And you just got your first write-up too, for high school.
When did you get this? Why do you always hide this from me?
Because, so, I, and you got it first, and you surprised me with it.
Anyways, it's time to go home.
This is my daily life.
my daily life for the rest of the year to get MVP, to get all my goals, to get all my written down goals. This is what it takes. This is what it takes to be where you want to be, to be successful. So that's it. I mean, that's my
Yeah. Very motivational.
That's all you really need from motivation. Like, subscribe, comment. I'm grateful to be back.
Okay.